given two random triangles. What are the odds that corresponding sides will join in three collinear points? One in infinity, also known as zero. What are the chances that corresponding corners will join in three concurrent lines? Ditto. On the other hand, it turns out that if you do luck out on either score, you also luck out on the other. Here we see two triangles whose corresponding corners all align with the yellow center and whose corresponding sides all meet in the red axis. Desargues discovered that these two conformities belong together. If two triangles are perspective from a point, then they are perspective from a line, and conversely. A triangle, regarded from its pointy side, may properly be termed a triangle or trigon. Regarded from its linear point, it may be called a trilateral or trigram. Let's first demonstrate this by experience, rather than by rigorous proof. To do so, construct your own. Start from the perspective point. Freely choose three lines in it, and in them, three points, such that each three-point has a point in each line. Label them to make the correspondences evident. For instance, A shares a guideline with A prime. Next, find the intersections of corresponding, repeat, corresponding sides. If your drawing goes off the page, which happens all the time in projective morphology, just tape on more paper. If you have worked precisely, these three intersections will line up. This method is more reliable than drawing random triangles until you luck out. So is this one. Start from the perspective line. Freely choose three points in it, and in them, three lines, such that each three line has a line in each point. Label them to make the correspondences evident. For instance, A shares an anchor point with A prime. Next, draw the lines connecting corresponding, repeat, corresponding corners. If your drawing goes off the page, which happens all the time in projective morphology, just tape on more paper. If you have worked precisely, these three connectors will converge. Oh, and by the way, the two trigons, or trigrams, need not be coplanar. You can see the one as the shadow of the other. This provides a foundation for perspective shadow drawing. For once you have a pair of Desargues triangles, any further point can be projected by continuation of the same method. Here is a Desargues configuration with one of the corners of one of the triangles infinitely distant You might see it as a shadow cast when the light source is level with the tip of the left-hand triangle. In that case, as we saw in the earlier presentation about the infinitely distant, the point of the shadow is infinitely distant, and its adjacent sides are parallel. That is, they meet in the infinite distance at the tip of the shadow. Here is one with one of the sides infinitely distant, which means identical with the infinitely distant line of the plane. That side meets the red axis at its infinitely distant point. Please note that in this and the following images, the Dessau triangles are colored more strongly. The lighter coloring indicates parts of the planes they lie in. Here is a proof of the theorem. First, for the case that the two triangles do not share a plane. If they are perspective from a point, then corresponding sides share a plane, namely, a side of the trihedron, whose tip is the perspective point, shown here in black. Therefore, they meet. And they can only meet where their two planes meet, namely in a line. Conversely, if the two triangles are perspective from a line, then each pair of corresponding sides determines a plane. That makes three planes, which in turn determine a point. If two coplanar triangles are perspective from a line, we choose one of them, here the black one, and from the same perspective line, construct a triangle perspective to it, lying in a different plane. The new triangle is therefore perspective to the other one as well, from the perspective line. And hence also from a point. Now consider the plane, not colored in here, determined by corresponding corners of the three triangles. For example, the rightmost corners. This plane contains the lines connecting these corners, and hence also the two perspective points, and hence the line connecting the two perspective points. And likewise for the other corresponding corners. Conversely, if coplanar triangles are perspective from a point, we choose one of them. Let's take the blue one this time, for reasons of affirmative action, and construct a triangle perspective to it, lying in a different plane. Now consider the plane, not colored in here, determined by corresponding corners of the three triangles, for example, the leftmost corners. It also contains the two perspective points, and hence, the connecting lines meet in that plane. And so do the lines connecting the other corresponding corners. The new triangle is thus perspective to the other one as well, from a point, and hence also from a line, which can only be the line common to both planes, where it is already established that corresponding lines of the blue and aqua triangles meet. Time for some visualization exercises. The Desargues configuration in space is a pentahedron. Five faces, namely three planes in the center of perspectivity and two in the axis, plus 10 edges, each containing 3 points, and 10 corners, each containing 3 lines. Now you can will any of these 10 corners to be the center of perspectivity, or any of the 10 edges to be the axis. Spatial visualization requires will, so you might need to pause and study each picture. Of course, each of these 10 pictures can also be seen as planar if you want. With every picture, you have to will a new spatial interpretation. Oh, you thought the triangles had to be separate? Another prejudice dropped. The center of perspectivity can also lie between two corners. Here, the two triangles do not intersect. They just touch edges at one point. Now you have seen all 10 possibilities. Quiz. What is the polar figure of this pentahedron with its 5 faces, 10 edges, and 10 corners? A pentagon with 5 corners, 10 edges, and 10 faces. What? A pentagon with 10 faces? Is that even legal? If you want to try to draw one on your own, pause now. Oh, yes, there are. Count again and you'll see. And after studying the pairs of Desargues triangles, each consisting of 3 lines in a plane, with their 3 points, we now need to expand our consciousness to grasp what may be termed pairs of Desargues sheaves, each consisting of 3 lines in a point, with their 3 planes. Triplanes was already taken. In this picture, the 2 Desargues sheaf points are at the top. Each sends down a green trihedron. The 2 sheaves, or trihedra, are perspective from a plane, namely the red plane below. That means the 3 intersection lines of corresponding faces are coplanar. And they are perspective from a line, namely the red line above. That means the 3 planes joining corresponding edges are collinear. And by invoking the triune deity of point, line and plane, we find new twin theorems. As mentioned in the first installment, for morphology in a point, we polarize by interchanging line and plane. If two trihedra are perspective from a plane, then they are perspective from a line, and conversely. And again, this picture turns out to be a fundamental configuration with 10 possible readings. In each of these 10 images, the red line is the axis of perspectivity, and the red plane opposite it is the plan of perspectivity. Sometimes the two sheaf points send their trihedra to the perspective plane from both sides. Now you have seen all 10 possibilities. Oh, and since Desargues Classic also worked when both triangles lay in the same plane, Desargues in a point must work when both sheaves lie in the same point. No way. The sheaves would just coincide, making the whole thing trivial. No, two distinct sheaves, or trihedra, in one point, analogous to the two distinct triangles in a plane. But now they don't intersect at all, except in the point. Wrong. Each face is a whole plane. In this case, the intersections of corresponding faces do happen to be coplanar. And since the planes determined by corresponding lines all intersect in this vertical, the sheaves are perspective from a line as well. Desargues even lets you connect a point with an intersection lying off the page without getting up and fetching more paper. Choose an axis of perspectivity. Construct a triangle with one corner in each of the given lines and the third at the given point. Then construct a second triangle, preferably somewhat distant, perspective to the other from the axis, with two of its corners in the given lines. The third corner lies in the required line. Now get up and fetch paper and tape and extend those lines to check your work. You know you want to. Yours aren't really that concurrent, are they? That's because of your chronically slipshod draftsmanship. Bye for now.